Okay, here we go. I'm punching it.
We're on.
So we'll give it 30 second delay and then I'll start talking.
Okay.
Uh-oh, we didn't even help out though.
Okay. It says we're live.
Hello, everyone. My name is Katy of the Greenland Quilter, and welcome to our very early in the day for me live. I want to welcome Janice of the Right Way to the channel. She is going to be sewing with me today. And yeah, I'm so happy about this. So as we're talking back and forth throughout the live, please go to her channel and like and subscribe. All of her stuff. Help her channel grow because we are all part of a tribe and we all can use your support. So now I'm going to turn it over to Janice.
Hello, everyone. Hi, Katy. It's so good to be here with you this morning. I am Janice, as she said. My channel is called The Right Way. And as you can hear, I'm from Jamaica. A small island in the Caribbean, and I live in North Carolina. I'm a teacher. I live here with my husband and two kids, and I started sewing just around when COVID hit. And I found YouTube channels on quilting and decided to try it, and I fell in love with quilting, and that's what I've been doing since.
Outstanding. Hello, Joy T, and hello, Joyce. We have two people so far.
Hello.
How long have you, when did you migrate? Did you migrate when you were an adult to the United States, or were you a young girl?
I migrated as an adult with kids. I've just been here about 7 and a half, almost 8 years.
Okay, cool. That's awesome. How did your kids feel about the migration?
It was hard for them to leave home and everything that they're familiar with and leave friends and family. But they like it here. When it was time to return, they didn't want to go. So we made the decision to stay so they could finish school, and you know it would have been more challenging for them to reacclimatize, I guess, to the school system, especially in Jamaica. So we decided to stay for them.
So does Jamaica have its own native tongue, or is English the native tongue?
English is the official language of Jamaica, but we do have a dialect that we call Patois.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but English is the main language. All transactions are done in English. Everybody speaks English, and all documentations, everything is in English. Or Patois is not recognized yet as an official language, but the culturists, people who believe in the culture, are trying to ensure that it becomes a recognized official language.
Yeah, that definitely needs to happen. I migrated to Greenland, and Greenlandic is the main language here, and they have fought really hard to keep it the main language instead of Danish becoming the main language. And currently there's some discussion that Danish is probably going to be pushed to the third language and English to the second, because Greenland's trying to, right now they're working on airports and things to make them bigger so that they can open up to more easier ways for people who want to come and see the country. Won't have to get on a cruise ship to do it. They can just fly over easily to parts of Greenland. And a lot of people need to learn the language. And I've lived here 12 years. And when I first moved here, the first 2 years, man, the language barrier beat me up, But I'm starting to see younger, the ages of maybe a fifth grader is what, 10? Maybe? 9 or 10
10,
years old.
11.
Yeah, I'm starting to see that age group speaking English. To start with, when I first moved here, none of them spoke English. And it was introduced into fifth grade, but parents don't push it, you know, or teachers won't push it. And, but one thing they've done is they are safeguarding their native tongue, because that's super important. And that's why I asked if yours had a native language and where that was, if it did.
Yes. When I was a little girl, it was sort of like frowned upon, taboo to speak patois in certain places, you know, and children were made to feel very badly if that's all they knew.
Yeah.
And because we were colonized by the British, you know, then the standard is the Queen's English. That's what we used to say back in the day. No, there's a queen. Yeah. We would say the Queen's English. So you have to speak the Queen's English. And but now more and more patois is being recognized and accepted in a wider, you know, more official places, not just in the homes and so on.
That's outstanding. Did you know that the United States has over 300 languages spoken all over the country? That people
I
have
knew
maintained.
There were many.
Yeah.
Yes.
They maintain their native tongue, and this is very important for everybody's culture. And that's I'm all about promoting that.
And funny enough, Jamaicans that live here, I speak more patois here than when I was in Jamaica.
Do the kids also speak that language as well?
They try. but they understand it. They understand it and they try. They know some words and some phrases and so on.
Oh, well, that's cool. But probably as they mature, they'll be more interested in learning it probably, because especially when it comes to culture. Because I did, as a Southern-raised girl, I didn't know what culture even meant until I moved to Greenland. I had no understanding of what culture was, because apparently my family didn't have culture. So, you know, other than the fact that, you know, my mother was a great Southern cook, and, you know, I will always remember all the good food that she made for us, you know, because we were raised on it. And, you know, every time I go back to the United States, it's like, let's go hunt down some okra so I can make okra, you know, or, you know, things like that.
That's culture. I mean, the culture is the way you live, you know, it's what is the norm for you and your family. So, and whatever that thing is that makes you nostalgic, that's your culture.
So my mother was born in Alabama, and she was one of 13 kids, and they were very poor. I mean, they didn't have money, and they cropped cotton. That's what they did for a living. And so it was a pretty rough rock, you know, life for them growing up. So sometimes she would eat things that would be like, you know, like she liked chitlins, and I'm like, no.
Yes.
No, thank you.
we have our versions of that in Jamaica too.
Yeah, see? You know, it's interesting what I see get eaten over here in Greenland too.
Like chicken feet. Chicken feet, there you go. And goat.
Yeah. It's goat pretty meat, interesting. You know?
Yeah.
I never had lamb until I moved here.
I think that those are delicious little things.
Yeah, little things. You know. Yep. Definitely. Let's say some more hellos to, we have Lori that just came in. Hi, Lori. Yep. Hello,
hi,
Robbie.
Lori.
Hi, Linda. We're just having a little pre-conversation talking about culture, and we're, Janice, now that I've said her name right, is from, because she's Jamaican, and I love the accent that you have, you know. People claim I have one, but I keep denying it.
Well, you do. when I tell my students, your accent, when I talk about their accent, they're like, we don't have an accent. You have an accent. We all have accents.
Yeah. And when I'm speaking Greenlandic, you know, they all get to start with, it used to be a big thing. You know, they laugh every time I try to get something off my tongue. Your tongue is so tight. That Southern accent, because they said they knew I must have been from, I guess, because I hear that I was from the South or something. And they're like, that Southern tongue of yours just gets in the way of everything.
Yes.
Okay, so
like my Jamaican accent does that too.
Yep. Tell everybody what you plan on working on again.
So I subscribed to the Vortex, the Legit Kits Block of the Month last year, and I'm a couple months behind. So I'm working on month 8 today. So that's this one. So I'm going to be selecting the fabric because I am working from my stash, and then I'm going to be assembling the block.
Okay. So what are
this is what it should look like when I'm done.
So how many months worth have you got done now?
It's 8. I've done 7, so this is the 8th month, and I believe there are 10 in all.
Okay.
So I have 2 more months.
Oh.
Yeah. We just got month 10, and I think that's the last one.
Okay. What do you think about the process?
I like it. It's kind of fiddly sometimes, but I like it a lot. It's very forgiving. And you get those nice points and so on. So I like it. It's interesting. I don't know that I would do another full, another full scale project like this. I don't know, but maybe smaller pieces, maybe more, less complex pieces, like, you know, like the half square triangles and those little blocks I would probably do, but I don't know if I would do another full-scale project like this. I don't know.
Oh, that makes sense. Have you been learning something about yourself as you've been making it?
That's a very good question. I've been learning that I don't care. I don't care if it's meaningful. I don't care if it's precise. It doesn't bother me, to be honest, if the points don't meet up. As long as I can see the pattern, you know, coming through, I don't really need for the points to be perfect. So I'm not going to rip unless I absolutely have to.
Yeah, I don't know if you've heard anything about this or not, but a while ago, back in November, I guess it was, Becca challenged me to reach 1,000 subscribers by Christmas Day. And if I did, she would buy me a legit kit because, I couldn't stomach the idea of paying such an exorbitant amount of money for one. Mm-hmm. And I made the subscribe count. And yesterday, my friend Christine and Georgia got the package. So when I get to the United States, I'll have it waiting on me. So, yep, I'm doing the mama polar bear with the baby.
Oh, it's pretty. I do love the quilts that you know, from the kits. Mm-hmm. They are lovely. But they are expensive for me as well.
Yeah.
So I only got the digital pattern of this one, which was $5 per month.
Oh, that's, wow, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, now they're not even offering digital.
Yes, they're not offering
problems.
Yeah.
Which is sad. Yeah. Okay, let me see if this link is going to work now. I just tried it. It didn't work. So I'd go back and see what was wrong with it. Come on, wake up, bot.
I saw someone, I'm not sure if it was the awkward quilter or... I'm not sure who it was, who did a exclamation point selfie, uh-huh. And it was and then so each person in the chat could put exclamation point selfie, and it would bring up their what? Channel. Yeah, but I don't know anything about the bot, so
maybe they programmed the bot to do that.
Yes, they programmed the bot. Exclamation point selfie, and it brought up their channel information.
Oh, well, so I have to think about fixing that.
That was like, yeah, because then you won't have to do something for everyone, you know? they could just put a selfie in the list. I don't remember who it was. If the person is here, they, or if anyone here saw that live, they could help us
I will
out with
look
that.
into that definitely. So,
So
here's
here's
what I'm working on. I'm working on which one of these. So, I have to do, you're probably wondering why I'm going backwards on my bump pop, but I'll explain it in a minute. So, I'm doing clue two. Uh-oh,
Oh.
there went all my things. Of bomb pot carnival.
Okay.
So, because I already have like the later ones done. I started like I didn't get my kit until like after
Oh.
2 months had gone by of the
Okay.
sewing, and I bought the whole kit for this one, and the other one I'm getting by the month. And so I did a sew with Sean, with the guy who sews, and I ended up doing that month with him. So that was why I lost one. Darn.
It fell on the floor.
Well, it's probably at the lab when you see it. Is it white color? No, it's okay. I know which one's seeing. So that's what I'm working on, y'all. All right, what are
Okay.
y'all working on? Put in the channel what y'all are doing. Let's see if we can get this channel moving while we're sewing. All right, this is what I have to do first. So what part of North Carolina do you live in?
I live in Durham.
Oh, you're,
Wait.
aren't you going to QuiltCon?
Am. I'm going on Saturday to Quilt Con. Raleigh's about 40 minutes or so away from where I am.
Okay.
So I am going to just drive over there with a couple friends, and I'll be there probably all day on Saturday.
Okay, good. I'm going to be there all 4 days.
Nice. Did
Gotta
you
make
find
sure
a
I'm
couple of
qualified
fun
enough to
that?
be high priced to fly, you know?
Yes. Yeah. That's pretty cool. I'm so happy it's my neck of the woods this year, because that's literally the only way I would be able to make it.
I
You
understand.
know?
I tried to keep my, let's see, I didn't go to the US last year. I go to the United States every other year. I have kids and grandkids to see, so but this time I'm just going to be doing East Coast stuff. I'll be My daughter and her husband and my youngest granddaughter will be meeting us up in Raleigh, and so I'll get to spend some time, and then I'll go back to Florida with them, and then I'm going to do some time in Florida and some time in Georgia. My son moved from California to Georgia, so he's just trying to get on his feet right now. And yeah, so it's all East Coast this time, no California. I'll do it the next trip because we have this thing that we want to do when we come to the US, and I think we're going to do it in 2026. I want to land in Miami, go to Fairchild Gardens, and then road trip from Miami down to Key West, because I've never seen Key West, and I lived in Florida all of my life, except for the first 5 years of my life anyway. And then road trip back up to see a friend that lives north of Tampa, and then spend some time in Lake City, and then drive all, I don't know if we'll probably drive because I want to see my birth town. I've never seen my birth town. I was born on the Navy base in Charleston, South Carolina, and I have never seen it. So that's on my bucket list. And then go up to Syracuse to see some friends, go across the Canadian border and see a Niagara Falls on the other side. And then when we come back, probably either drive or fly to Chicago, and then get on the Zephyr train. The Zephyr's a 2-day trip on the train, and you go from Chicago to San Francisco. to travel through a lot of the northern states. And this will be a real treat for me and for him because I won't have to drive. And he'll get to see more of the United States as well since he's a Greenlander. Right. And and we really like coming through San Francisco anyway, you know. He finally got to see the bridge up close and personal. The last time we were there, I picked him up from the airport and I drove through all that crazy going through town to get to the bridge thing. And it was a little nerve-wracking driving through that because, you know, I don't drive over here. So, you know, getting my feet wet all at once.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, we got some really good pictures of the bridge and we had a good time. And then we'll just go from there to where my other daughter lives and spend a little time with them there. And
that's
then
good.
Go back home again.
Yeah. I've never been to the West Coast. So that's one, that's a future plan, a future trip that I'd like to take.
You should figure out what you want to see and where. I personally, my daughter lives in Hanford, so you can drive about an hour and a half, maybe two, to go to Yosemite. And I've been to Yosemite twice now, and I want to go back again. I don't like getting there because the roads do this. And if you're sitting in the back seat, it really sucks. Because you're slow down, speed up, and you're doing all this little meandering thing. But when you get up where you need to get and you get to walk in the forest, oh my God. I can sit there all day and be perfectly content with that.
Yeah.
Hello, Catherine. How are you? And how's everything going? So the only one that's doing anything is Robin, just coffee, nothing else?
They're just watching today or resting.
Chilling. Is there any kind of sewing things that goes on in Jamaica?
Yes. My mom was a seamstress when I was growing up.
Okay.
When I was a little girl, she made baby clothes, which I would have to, you know, cut off the scalloped edges and cut out the buttonholes and sew the buttons on. And dressmaking and making curtains, comforters, you know, all of those things is very popular in Jamaica. But I never saw anyone make a quilt.
Okay.
And I mean, I guess it makes sense. Jamaica is a tropical country. Warm. I never actually saw anyone make a quilt until I started quilting. Then I heard, oh, this person quilts and that person quilts. I had no idea.
Well, at least you had someone, you know, you were exposed to sewing. Did you do anything? Other than you said you were cutting scallops and sewing on buttons, did you also sew?
So, and another thing, Katy, is that when I was growing up in any case, schools, you did sewing at school.
Okay.
It was a part of your home economics. So you did sewing and cooking at school. So I did learn to sew. My mom, you know, I would always be sewing on her machine, tinkering with her machine and sewing scraps together and so on. But at school, I learned to use a pattern to sew like a skirt, you know, an apron, that sort of thing.
So it was like a home economics class, like what I had in middle school.
Yes. Yes.
Because that was where I got my first, I mean, my mother, she made all of our dresses that we went to school and I got a few school pictures where you can see they were simple dresses and she had like these little eyelet lace things going down in two rows, you know, just very simple things that she made. So she sewed, but I don't recall thinking I wanted to learn. And then when I did the home economics class in it must have been the seventh or eighth grade, I don't know which. We made aprons. And man, I just was like, wow, this is really fun.
Yeah.
And And I came home one afternoon and I said, Mom, I want to learn how to make my own clothes. My parents joined this church, and one of the things that happened when we joined the church is us girls are no longer allowed to wear pants or shorts or cut our hair or any pierce, you know, wear jewelry, all this kind of stuff. And when you'd go to the store to buy dresses and skirts and stuff, they would be so expensive. And I had a part-time job at a cactus nursery, so I always had a little money. And I would go up one day. I told Mom, I want, will you show me how to thread the machine? So she did. And then I went to the fabric store and bought something I liked and bought a pattern. And that was the first time I started making my own clothes. And I realized this is like making my own clothes was more, I don't know, because I got to make what I wanted to make. Because you can make three dresses for the price of one $50 dress coming from Katy's.
Yeah.
You know, and so I made all of my, the only thing I didn't really make all the time was like, if I made skirts, I would go to the store and buy maybe shirts because I, you know, was being lazy. But dresses, I made all of my dresses.
Yeah. Wow. I wasn't interested, to be honest, in sewing either. I was like, ugh, I don't want to do that.
Yeah.
But what I was interested in were the things that felt like crafts to me, like knitting, crochet, embroidery. Those things I loved, and my mom taught me how to do those things as well. So I didn't learn much about sewing, but I did learn, you know, crochet and embroidery and so on. And
I've always wanted
to have a machine. So when I got the machine, I just immediately started.
That home ec class also did embroidery, and so that's, I think that was the only time I ever did any kind of embroidery. Once I reached adulthood, I just pick it back up. But I do crochet. That thing you see behind me, that's crochet.
Oh, I've always wondered. It's really lovely.
Thank you. It has 32 colors in it, and I use number 3 cotton thread.
Wow.
But it was a crochet along. It's called Mandala Madness. And, so it was a year-long crochet along. You did it with other people. There was like 3,000 people doing it. So we've got to be cool people, and I learned a lot of new skills there, because when I started out, my aunt from that lived in Georgia, she's the one that taught me how to do basic crochet skills, and the rest that I knew how to do, I had learned on my own. But when I started this, it's like, oh my God, there's things that I've never done before. And I have to say that as each row went by, I got better at it.
Yeah, that's the thing about it. I'm trying to make sure the tension is, you know, consistent and the stitches are consistent. It takes practice.
Yep, definitely.
Yeah.
Do any of your kids have any interest in learning how to make a quilt?
Funny story. I taught my daughter to crush. Nobody's interested in quilting. Okay. Nobody's interested in quilting. But I taught my daughter to crochet when she was a little girl, and she could do the chain stitch. So she would just make these long chains, and she was not interested in doing anything else. And then a few years ago, she decides she wants to crochet. And do you know, instead of asking me, she went on YouTube. So YouTube taught her how to crochet. But no one is interested in quilting yet. They love to see the finished quilt, but no one is interested yet. So
yeah, they got other young things to do.
Yeah, yep.
Hello to all of you who just came in. Let me see who I missed. Okay, let me go backwards here. Let's see. Hello, Fallon. Hello, Robin. Hello, Shelley. Hello, Candace. Hello, Laura. Hello, Chloe. Hello, Andrea. And I'm probably not saying her name right either. Hi, Nellie. Hello, Kelly. Hello, Stephen, right, of Bland Designs. Hello, Martha. Good to see you, girlfriend. Hello, Kathy. And
Hey.
anyone else I might have missed. So what are y'all working on? Share with us. Oh, and say hello to Janice. She's my newest tribe member. She's come to sew with me, and I've been very much looking forward to sewing with her. And we've been talking about her culture a bit and you know, sharing these. You know, I share stuff about Greenland, and I'm always wanting to learn more about other people's cultures as well. And this is a great platform to do it on while we're sewing. So, you know, I'm so happy about getting her on here, and I hope that we get to sew again in the future as well. You know, the more we sew together, the more we get to know each other, and the more you guys get to know her as well. So if you haven't, if you're not subscribed to her channel, please click on the link and go over and show some love and help her channel grow too, because we're all part of the same community, and any help that you can give her would be appreciated as well. Hello, Debbie. Hello, somebody else just walked in the door. Oh, hi, Charlotte. How are you? So tell us what you're working on. Andrea says I'm saying her name just right. And if anyone wonders how to pronounce my last name, it's Jame. Oh, okay. Is it Jame or Yame? Because here in Greenland, J's are the yaw sound. So I'll tell you a funny joke. My last name is spelled J-O-E-L-S-E. I'll write it in the channel. Now, my American self was calling it Joelsen.
Joelsen, yes.
It's not Joelsen. So for 2 years, I was my husband never corrected me, which, you know, he should have. So when I was in the commune one day, we were doing something, and she says, what's your name? And I said, Catherine Joelsen. She's like, huh? What? And I repeated it. She says, can I see your, write it down. She says, Joelsen, not Joelsen. That's why I got that look I would get. I'm good too, Kate. I'm good too, Charlotte. And Debbie says she subscribed to you, Janice. Martha said she'd be right back. So,
thanks, Debbie.
Show some love. Candace says, I'm finally finishing the lighthearted quilt that I started on your live. All right, Candace. That's great. I am working on Bomb Pop, and Janice is working on Vortex,
yes.
So y'all say hello to Denise. Okay, so I got all of these done. Hope you didn't get too terribly distracted when I was doing it.
So I should have done this before, but I'm going through and picking up the fabrics for this block. And whatever I haven't picked out, I will pick out from my stash.
Okay.
Because I'm working from my stash on this quilt. So, so I'm just going through. So I know it looks like I'm not sewing anything, but I'm trying to get there.
Lori says she just subscribed to your channel too, Janice.
Thanks, Lori. Welcome. I hope you enjoy what you see there.
All right, where's my little roller? Oh, there it is. I'm always chasing my roller down.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool.
Hi, Jim. I think I might not have said hi to you. How are you doing? Andrea says the French pronunciation sounds like chame, but it doesn't matter. Oh, my husband's people immigrated from Cuba and Puerto Rico and are Spanish speaking, but Ellis Island made them French. Oh,
Ooh.
chamay. Ah,
Chamay.
see? We would not know this if y'all didn't tell us. One of the designers of Stronger Together that I'm working on. Her name is I was calling her what was I saying? How was I saying? Bickety. It was her name is actually the Katy.
Katie.
Yeah. And she's from the
Yes.
Dominican Republic. Her parents migrated them when she was 15 to the United States. So she also her mother and her grandmother and her great grandmother were sewers of clothing.
Yeah. Yep. My grandmother as well was a seamstress as well, and my mother. So yep, I get that. And my grandfather, he moved from Panama to Jamaica.
Oh, interesting. What language does people in Panama speak?
They speak Spanish.
Okay.
Yes.
So he was bilingual or trilingual, I guess, or something.
I don't speak very much Spanish. I keep trying to learn. I did learn Spanish in school. But I think my brain is getting old, so it's not
The
sticking
saying
anymore.
is, if you don't use it, you lose it. Because I used to speak Spanish. I can still read some of it, but I
Yeah.
had studied Spanish in college, and because you have to take a foreign language, two semesters of it, and so I
Yes.
was able to speak it, but then I didn't have anyone to practice it on.
Right. And then also you have to be, you have to be brave. You can't be scared of making mistakes.
Yep,
And
that's
I'm
right.
not brave. I'm very, very, very shy, very scared. So yeah.
I butcher Greenlandic on a regular basis. There's some sounds. There's a you have a dub. Let me type the word in the channel. But this word, ILLILLU, that means you're welcome. And you have when you're saying the word, my ears hear this sh sound, which is a s sound. But when you're saying the word, the tongue goes to the top, the roof of your mouth, and you're pushing sound out the cheeks when you're saying it. And I'm getting better at saying isusu, but it's not quite there. But it means you're welcome. So LLs te tease me, RLs tease me, NGAs tease me. I've had to learn that when you see a word with a T, it's probably not a T, it's a D sound, because the language is quite different. But over time, I've learned these, and the taxi drivers have been really a big, they've been really good about teaching me Greenlandic. So I have about a 50 word vocabulary now. Should be more, but at my age, it's so hard.
Yes, it's so hard.
But I can read Danish, but I don't speak any Danish at all. And the Danish that I can read is what's in the grocery store or what's in a restaurant.
KQ.
So I don't know what you'd call somebody like me that can read some of it, speak some of it, and speak English too as well.
Partially fluent,
Yeah, something.
multilingual.
Or fluent challenged. My husband speaks three languages. He speaks Greenlandic, Danish, and English, and his English is very good. Okay, let me go back to the channel. Andrea says, I cannot speak anything but English, but I'm learning a few new words of Spanish from listening to them. Andrea says, I cannot roll my R's for the life of me, so they laugh at me when I try. Yeah, when I first started trying to learn to say something, I got lots of laughter. But now I realize they're not laughing at me. They're laughing because you know, it makes them happy that you're trying.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because, you know, Greenlandic. So with Greenlandic, one word is an entire sentence. So, like, I love you is Asabaget. And I'll put it in the chat so they can see the spelling. That one word means I love you. Or if I put Maka Asabaget, that means I miss you. You notice there's a trend here at the end. The end of the word is the description part. And the other part, I don't really understand all this, what the front part means yet. Mm-hmm. But trying to think of one, like this word. Notice the ending is, that doesn't look like I spelled it right. Notice the end of the word is the same as the Asabaget or the Maka Asabaget. That means hugs this is to you, that word. Icky Likit, a car. Yeah, I have trouble saying that one, but it means hugs and kisses to you.
It's language is so interesting.
Language
is so interesting. Or Jamaican dialect is very, very colorful.
I'll bet.
And sometimes when you say something in English, it just doesn't have the same impact.
No.
You know? It's, you know. So.
Andrea says, my husband was in special forces in the army and speaks Russian, Italian, French, and Spanish. When he gets mad, he cusses at all four of them at the same time. Do you know what the...
Yes.
You know the English S word. You know what I'm talking about, the S cuss word? Mm-hmm. In Danish, it's Satan. S-A-T-A-N, like the devil, Satan.
That's funny.
Yep. I'm like, who decided that we'd use the same term as what you see in the Bible, you know?
Yeah.
Too comical. All right, so what are we putting together here?
All the fabric for this so I can actually do some sewing.
Oh, I gotta be careful. If I get this goofed up, I'll be in big trouble. Okay, hi, Mary G. How are you? If you haven't subscribed to Janice's channel, can you mosey on over there and help her out, please? Show some love. Because we're all part of the same community.
When my students, when I'm teaching, if they hear me revert to my Jamaican dialect, they know that they're in trouble. They know they're in trouble.
Uh-oh. What grade do you teach?
Right now I'm teaching 5th and 6th. I teach two subjects. Right now I'm teaching performing arts. So I teach 5th and 6th drama. And I do dance with the little ones.
Nice.
Prior to that, I was a regular classroom, elementary classroom teacher.
That's outstanding.
Yeah.
Jim says, enjoy your day. Time to get breakfast and take meds. Okay, have a great day, Jim. Thank you for dropping in. I have a live tonight, just so you know.
Have a great day. I'm actually going to start sewing now. I am planning to do some sewing.
My dad's father came from England. My maiden name is Wright, says Andrea.
Okay. Oh.
So maybe it's a British name?
Wright is my married name, but my maiden name is also from England. It's beadle, B-E-A-D-L-E.
Oh, interesting.
I don't know if any of you are literature people and read Oliver Twist when you were younger or at all.
Uh-huh.
And the person that took Oliver to the orphanage, his job was he was a beadle. His name was Mr. Bumble. So Mr. Bumble was a beadle. So as a kid with the last name Beadle in class reading that Mr. Bumble was a beadle, you know, there was a lot of teasing about my name.
I can imagine. Like, yep. Look at that person's name. I don't think my maiden name started out as Oglesby when it first, where it came from overseas in Europe. Mm-hmm. Because when you go back, when you try to go back, there's a different spelling altogether from what it was. So somehow it got changed, I don't know, during migration or something.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so I need WLCY. LX.
Debbie said, good idea, Mary S. I have printer tape. I usually use silver a bar soap too. I wonder what they're talking about. I missed what y'all were talking about. What are y'all talking about? They're using painter tape. Someone is. Maybe they're talking about quilting, line making. I'm going to use painter tape on the quilt I'm going to try to quilt during the line. Kelly says, my married name is Mueller. Now you know why our dog's name is Ferris. We have Moolers that live in Mueller here in our town also. But it's not spelled that way. It's spelled a little bit different. But I have a feeling it's all from the same place.
Yeah.
This is the Danish last name. Debbie says she's marking fabric on the right side. Hi, Mona. How are you? If you haven't subscribed to Janice's channel the right way, please do. Help her out. Show your love.
Okay, number one is LX.
Kelly says, but that is the Canadianized spelling. The proper German way does not have an E. There is just the... interesting. No, it's okay, Andrea. We're not... This channel's a relaxed channel. We can talk about most anything except for the more controversial stuff. I would rather not have anger rolling through my channel.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can give an earful just as good as anyone else, but yeah, that's out of it. think there's enough anger in the world right now to consume
absolutely
all of it. Yeah, it consume all of it if we let it.
Yeah, absolutely.
I haven't seen so many angry people. God, goodness. What you working on, Mona?
I haven't sewn a stitch yet, but I'm getting there.
I got you distracted. I'm sorry. We're not on a time clock here, so you know.
It's okay.
I don't know how long you can sew, but I'm game for as long as you want to.
Okay. At least I have to get at least some sewing done. I mean,
definitely
some sewing. But what happens with the legit kits is because I'm pulling from my stash, every time I do a new block, I have to see what I've pulled already and then, you know, pull the rest. So it's interesting, to say the least.
Yeah, I can imagine. When I get the polar bear, go ahead.
Yeah. I was going to ask if anyone in the chat, you know, has worked on a legit kit or is working on the Vortex.
Yeah, that's a good question. Hi, Donna from Dragonflies. Anyone doing a Vortex?
Yeah, what were you saying about the
the polar bear?
The polar bear, yeah.
Yeah, when I get to the U.S. and I get to see the color legend, I think I'm going to look up to see if I can find any of the kits that I might be used to some of the colors.
Mm-hmm.
You know, take some of the colors out and use the kits in its place on some parts of the polar bear.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll give texture.
Right, right.
There's always such great colors of the piece out there to do that with. And I'm in love with the piece, so there's that. Speaking of sewing, well, Do you like modern or do you like traditional the best?
I don't even know what's the difference between modern and traditional. I have not tried very. I mean, I feel like I like what I like. If I see a fabric that I like it. And if I don't, I don't. And I've never learned the difference between modern and traditional. So I don't know.
I wonder if the Vortex would be considered modern.
I feel like it would be, but I don't know. Someone will have to educate me on that.
So this mom pop I'm working on, that would be like traditional piecing, the usual traditional colors.
Mm-hmm.
My Stronger Together, it's more of a modern style.
I don't know.
I might give a better definition than I just gave of that.
Finally sewing.
All right.
First stitch of the morning.
And I got to put these sewn together. Now what do I do? I'm going to hook them together. And I've got to make sure I've got this going. Oops, I got it. Bonuses. I will be leaving when Donnell goes live. I think that is in an hour. Okay? Okay. He goes live in a minute. Andrew says, no, I am old and on SS, so cannot afford all those fancy kits. Mona says, no, I'm not crazy about legit kits. Yeah, I couldn't afford to buy one. This is a gift from Becca. Kelly says, I'm leaving when the boys get out of bed. It's 6:52. Whoa, that's for me. Andrew says, what time do you go live tonight? 7 Greenland time, which would be 4 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Frank says, hey, all good morning. Just checking in, getting ready for a busy day. How's the weather in Florida, Frank? Andrea says, you are not old enough. I know traditional, but I also like the bright modern colors, too. And Kelly, yeah, the answer to my question. And Kelly says, I can't afford legit kits either. Maybe sometime in the future. See, many of us can't afford it.
I can't afford it either.
The only reason I have a polar bear is because it was gifted to me. I guess is the best way to make an explanation of that.
First seam sewn for the morning.
Oh, yes. Cool. Are you using
I can't afford it. What's that?
Is that batik on that one side?
No, it's not. It's not. But it's really Mona pretty.
Yeah, it's very pretty. Mona says, yeah, it's too expensive for me too. And then Debbie says, Kelly, on the laptop, it just verifies a robot, but won't let me know your email address side. Frank says, it's 37 degrees this morning in Florida. Ooh, that's cold.
37 in Florida.
Yeah, wow. It happens in Florida. It's always fun when people are like, it cannot possibly be that cold before. Oh, yes, it does.
My sister must not be very happy. My sister lives in Florida.
What part of Florida?
She's in Fort Lauderdale, is she? Where is she?
If she's in Fort Lauderdale, it might be warm enough down there.
Yeah. Yeah, she's near to Fort Lauderdale for sure.
When my mother met my dad, she was working in Fort Lauderdale.
Okay.
She was a waitress. She worked down there and sent money home to her parents to help them. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the only way I was able to afford this is because they offered a digital download for the Vortex, which costs $5 per month. So that was the only way I was able to afford it. And I don't know that I will do another one because I just, you know, it's not something that, you know,
that you're interested in doing.
I don't think I can. Yeah, I'm not. Yeah. I don't know if it's, you know, something I would want to do consistently. So hats off to those people who do. But I don't know if it's for me. But I'm enjoying this one.
I'm glad you're enjoying it. So that's a good thing.
There's some.
Frank says it's nice in Fort Lauderdale. I think you have to make me a new anger. Mini thread sticking out of that one. Yeah.
Okay, where's my little pin? Does anybody else constantly lose things when they're sewing like I do?
Yeah, I've lost my seam ripper again. I have no idea where it went to.
Can't find the pin.
Now, Kelly says she's... Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, I'm just, you know, using... A pin is a dangerous thing to lose.
Yeah.
What does Kelly say?
Kelly says, I'm going to do the Violet Craft Woof, but the PDF pattern is about $25. I think that horse pattern, paper piecing horse one I got, it's of the neck and head, I think I bought that from Violet Craft, and I'm definitely thinking about working on, well, maybe it's the whole horse. I don't remember now. I have to go look for it. I think it was the head and neck. Because I want to do a horse.
Do you like horses?
Yeah, I had horses before I moved to Greenland. I was racing.
Oh, wow.
Speaking of that.
Oh.
I was going to show a picture. I took those out of here to put them away. Yeah, I had four horses before I moved to Greenland, and one of them I did Western barrel racing timed event. Wow. And I was doing pretty good with him. And when I left to move here, I was in first place when I left. And I moved here in August, and if I'd stayed until January, I probably would have won a saddle.
Wow.
Long enough to get to that spot. I had spent 2 years before that in second place. And I have two trophy breast collars. That's the strap that runs across the chest of the horse and is attached to the saddle. And it has the date of when I won the breast collar. But, you know, it was just a small local riding club I belonged to. I wasn't NBHA material, but my horse was. He had been racing all of his life. Hey, Teresa Louise. Welcome, welcome. Oh, wait, maybe they're just talking about her. Yeah, she's doing those horse heads, and they are gorgeous. I thought she had come in the channel, but it would be awful early her time. She's on Pacific time.
Oh. Yeah.
John Walker is that early or on the West Coast to watch him. I think that is so cool. I make sure I'm putting this the right way. Yeah.
All right, second theme song.
Nice.
Lost that pin.
What machine are you sewing on?
So I have a Brother LX3817, which is one of those little Walmart ones. I actually bought it on Facebook Marketplace for $40. And
that's a good price.
This little machine is a workhorse. Although recently it has been giving a little bit of trouble, and I know it cannot be. The machine repairman told me it's more expensive to repair it than replace it. So,
yeah.
So it will not be replaced. It will not be repaired. It will be replaced. I'll just use it until it dies.
Disposable sewing machine.
Yep. But it has really worked. It has done everything. And I can't afford long arming services
Yep.
yet. And so I do all my long arming, my quilting on this little machine.
You
I
must have a
think
lot of patience.
that's why I hand sew a lot. I hand quilt a lot because I love hand quilting, and it's just easier to hand quilt than to push the quilt through this little tiny space.
Yeah.
So I do a lot of hand quilting.
I was watching you hand sew that quilt you were working on the other day that I commented on. And
Yes.
I'm just sitting there and I'm like, she's just doing it like it's nothing. I wish somebody would teach me how to hand sew because I have no, yeah, I don't know how to hand sew anything. I barely
That's
can
this
handle
one.
it. I used to, when I would make my dresses, I'd go in the living room after I finished the dress and I'd say, Mom, will you hand my dress for me? Because she never would sit down and really teach me how to
This
hand sew.
is the one.
Yeah, see what,
Yeah.
let me pin you and then let's show it to everybody. This is what she's hand sewing. Take a look, you guys. Isn't that pretty? She's hand sewing that whole thing.
Yeah.
See you later, Andrea. Wow, that's you put quite a bit of it together since I saw it on the video the other day.
Yeah. And I do, when I'm traveling, I usually have something that I'm working on with me. And also I volunteer at a hospice. And when I'm sitting with the patient, I'm usually sewing as well.
Oh, that's cool. That's a
And
great way
so,
to pay it back.
yes, I love volunteering. I think it's something that everyone should do if they can, you know?
Yep.
It's, yep.
Okay, we've got that one
Hopefully, I won't
done.
lose that pin.
Okay, I'll be right back. I'm going to press these two blocks.
Okay. Thank you, Robin. Thank you, Debbie. I actually purchased this fabric from Walmart, and I love it. It's beautiful. It feels like the same quality as the other fabric that I generally sew with. But I like it too. Thank you.
Have you ever bought fabric from Hobby Lobby?
I have never bought fabric from Hobby Lobby. When I first started quilting, I went to Joann's, and I was shocked at the price of the fabric. I was like, fabric is so expensive.
Yeah, the fabric from Hobby Lobby is not too terribly bad priced, and the fabric seems to be really nice. I've bought some from
Yeah.
there.
I've never gone to, I'm afraid of going to certain stores because, you know, I don't want to spend the money that I didn't intend to spend, you know.
Yeah, I hear you.
So I'm always nervous when I go to certain stores because I know if I go to a craft store or a quilt store, I'm going to be in trouble.
The
So I try
willpower
to
must be thin.
avoid. Yes. It's always a battle.
Yep. It's so many pretty things.
Yes. And then I take my husband with me and to try and keep me in line. But he loves pretty things too.
Yeah, I hear that.
So he's like coming over to me with his hand full. I'm like, what? You're supposed to be stopping, preventing me from buying anything. Yeah.
No, not today. I'm going to join you for the fun.
Yeah, he spoils me. That's for sure. I know Temu is controversial, but I've purchased a few things on Temu too. Not fabric, but notions. I've purchased notions on Temu.
Were they good quality?
Yeah, like this pair of scissors here. I purchased this on Temu.
Wow, those are a big pair of scissors.
Yep.
And they cut
And
okay? They keep their
it
blade and
does.
everything?
It cuts perfectly, just like the others
Wow,
that
that's awesome.
I have. I mean, this is not, this is like, this is a Singer, very old pair of scissors, and the one from Temu, and they cut the same.
Wow. Is the
I'm not
same
enough, I'm not advertising, I'm not advertising Temu now. I'm just
Yeah, you're doing what you can afford to do.
I'm doing what I can afford. So, yeah.
Was the Singer scissors expensive?
No, this was I inherited this.
Oh,
I
okay.
inherited this from it was the grandparent of a friend of mine, and she was left with her items when she passed away, and so I inherited the Singer scissors from her. When I like when I'm using the doing the legit kits items, and I'm cutting through paper and fabric, I didn't want to use
Yeah.
those other, so that's why I got this from Temu, and it's quite good. I actually got a pair of pinking shears from them as well, because I've just always wanted one but never been able to afford it. And
Steven says, he says, I have bought a number of things on Temu, and I have not been disappointed with the ex except with the exception of fabric. It is not horrible, but I would not use it in a quilt.
Nice.
You guys sh see where I showed you piece I've sewn together? Nobody said anything. Debbie says, I hate to say goodbye. I have a lot to do this morning. Have a great day. Yeah, you too. Thank you for dropping in. That's you can always finish watching the replay later. Anyone, and let me share Janice's channel link again if you haven't gone over there. Robin says, I love the Market of Marion. I've never heard of that one. Market of Marion, junk in the trunk. They must be flea market.
My idea of a vacation is going to a thrift store, quilt store, flea market, antique store. That those are things that I really enjoy.
Interesting.
So whenever we go on vacation, I always look for the nearest antique store, the nearest quilt store, the nearest thrift store, and that's all I want to do.
Yeah. All I want to do is have some fun.
Yep. Yeah,
Have some fun until the sun comes up on a Santa Monica Boulevard.
When I first started quilting, I quickly realized how expensive it is. And I went on a Facebook beginners group and I said, you know, I'm realizing how expensive this hobby is, you know. Can anyone share with me some ideas how we can do this on a budget? And one of the persons on that that Facebook account said, well, maybe this isn't the hobby for you.
That's rude.
And I was like, what?
They really so, said that? Gosh, people.
Yes, she said, maybe this isn't the hobby for you. So that's one of the reasons I'm not on Facebook. I just found that my experience on Facebook was less than encouraging.
Yeah, I have my Facebook set where you can't just come strolling in and put your two cents on anything I comment if you're not on my friends list, and I have it set to private. And yeah, mm-hmm. And if you're going to be snarky and mean as a friend, then you don't belong on there either.
Yeah.
So I think my friends list is like, I don't know, around 400 maybe. And that might sound like a lot, but most of them are people I went to high school with, or people I've gotten close to over the last 30 years, you know, but everything else is done through my group or whatever.
Yeah.
Because I want to be able to, you know, if I say something on my Facebook that's controversial, I want to be able to say it and not have to worry about someone being, you know, venomous about it.
Yeah.
But sometimes I'll say something because I'm thinking about it. But I don't do it that often, though.
All right, one block done. Or one part of the block is done.
Oh, it looks good. Super good. Thank you. Do you have a design board where you're going to be putting it up or as you start piecing it together?
I do have a small design board because right there behind me.
Yeah.
And if the blocks that I've done before are up there. I don't know if you can see it. So, yeah.
If you ever buy a new TV, cut the box apart and you can make, especially if it's a big TV, you can cut the box apart and you'll have two pieces. And then you can duct tape the two pieces together and you can turn that into a portable design board because I have one of those in my sewing room.
Oh, that's cool. That's very interesting.
I'm sewing in my living room right now because my sewing room got destroyed by the neighbor's trampoline.
Wow. This is my sewing space. I'm in the dining room. I live in a small space, so I have to make the most of it.
Yeah, it's weird being in this cramped spot.
I'm hoping one day to have my own sewing room, but right now, this is what it is. And it's okay. It's good.
Yep.
You know.
As long as you can sew. Katie, I have no breaks. If I think it, I stay it. Frank says she doesn't always have much, but sometimes. And then Frank says, that's all that counts. Yeah, but Robin, there's a difference between speaking your mind
and being mean, right?
Yeah, and without being, and you can do it without being hateful and mean. There are some people that think that their way is, or their beliefs are the only way, and anything else is, yeah. We used to be a polite society, and now we're not. Now, that kind of stuff hasn't worn off over here on Greenlanders, though. Greenlanders mm-hmm. spend a lot of time shaking their head, like, why?
Yeah.
The biggest uproar that happened over here that has to do with our home country is the day that Donald Trump mentioned buying Greenland. Oh, my God.
What?
You would not believe the comments. We, the Greenlandic people, are not for sale. You will not buy our country because we're not for sale. I was like, whoa, you made some people angry when you said something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize that, you know, when that comment came out and I was in town and I was getting stalked about it. Why would he say he thought he could buy the Greenlandic people? Because see, I made that comment to my son and my husband's daughter. I was telling him about it. He says he's not trying to buy the Greenlandic people. He wants to buy the country. I said the country is the Greenlandic people.
Yeah. See why.
That's how they view this country.
I found that missing pin.
All right.
Oh my goodness.
I think this country's going to grow a lot because especially that the airport that they're extending in Nuuk is going to be turned into, it'll be, I think, 2,800 meters long. And I don't remember how wide it's going to be, but it can land wide body jets. And they're opening the whole international, and they're switching it to calling it an international airport, and it will be completely open in December. They start their first intercontinental flight between Nuuk and Canada in May. That starts in May, and I am so happy about this because that means that once they start doing intercontinental flights between Nuuk and the United States, no more having to go to Denmark to fly to the U.S. I can save some money.
Yeah. Yep.
Because it's expensive to fly. It costs me a lot of money. Because where I live at, I have to get on a helicopter. Then I fly to a small airport. A small airport. And then I get on a Dash 8 propped passenger plane that holds about 50 people. And then mm-hmm. we fly. So if I'm flying out, then I would fly from there in the winter months. In the winter months, if you fly on Tuesdays and Thursdays, you would go from Narsarsuaq to Kangerlussuaq, which is up north of Nuuk. And if you flew in the summers and went on Tuesdays and Thursdays, there would be a 737 that you could actually fly from Narsarsuaq straight to Copenhagen. So mm-hmm. because I'm flying in February, that means I have to go through Kangerlussuaq to go to Denmark. And then I'll spend 3 days there before flying to the United States. And then it'll be Copenhagen, Amsterdam, JFK, and then Raleigh.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's a lot of traveling.
Yep. So that's why I'm getting there on a Monday, so that I can sleep off jet lag.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Did you say you're traveling in a helicopter on one of those legs?
Yeah, the first leg. I first love leg. The helicopter is a lot of fun. That's why I get all my live videos. Every time I get on the helicopter these days, I start videoing and I sit by the window. So it started out with me taking pictures. And then when mm-hmm. I have some video back then, but only did them like in 1 minute increment, but now every time I get on the helicopter, I try to make them 5 to 8 minute increments and stop and then restart again. Because, you know, depending on which side of the helicopter I'm on, and depending on what time of the year I'm flying, you know, Greenland looks different.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure I'm going to see ice on the water that's flying in this time. So that's going to be fun to share when I make the videos for it.
All right.
But the helicopter's a lot of fun. I definitely like it a lot. I know where I'm going to miss it when we get there. We're also getting a little airport here, finally. It'll be finished in 2026, and it's going to have a 1,800 meter long runway on it, and which is about just a tad bigger than the one in North Arkansas. So it'll be able to land 737s as well. And once that happens, I won't be riding on the helicopter anymore. It'll be using a passenger plane. But it's good because this needs to happen so that we can, because our town is spread out, but it's so small because the pandemic really hurt our town. So a lot of businesses lost money, and so some of them decided, let's just go open our business in Nuke, the capital, because right now Nuke is growing in leaps and bounds. When I traveled through there the last time I was traveling, I couldn't believe all the cranes. There was cranes everywhere where they were building housing and different styles of housing and businesses and stuff. I mean, it was everywhere. And it's spreading out. The town is spreading out as they're doing it.
Yep. So once the transportation, you know, grows, access to the community increases, you know, and people have more access.
There'll be more jobs and everything else from that happen. Robin says, with me, if you ask, I don't sugarcoat anything.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I'm Jamaican, so I'm very direct. But, you know, you can always be kind.
Yeah.
You know?
It took me a long time as an adult, it's just been a more recent affair. It took me a long time to learn how to stand up for myself. You know, you've been beaten down by two different men in your life, and you know, it started in childhood all the way into adulthood. You know, defending yourself wasn't something you got a chance to do.
Right. Yep.
But now now if somebody does something that I don't think is correct or they shouldn't be talking to me like that, I'll say something about it. I don't show disrespect to anyone.
I don't know. I don't think that. I mean, you know, that's that was one of the hardest things for me to deal with, moving to this country as a teacher, was disrespect.
Yep.
It was just not something that I had to deal with in a school, in a classroom in Jamaica, you know.
Yeah,
a student would never be disrespectful. Well, I mean, I won't say never, you know, you do have the occasions, but it's definitely not the norm.
Yeah, because the repercussions of being disrespectful would cost you something.
Exactly.
So anything from, well, back then they used corporal punishment. I can remember when I was in the, third or fourth grade, more like, I'm still in elementary school, and we went out we were on recess, and there was a pine tree stand where a lot of times us girls would go and play around the pine stand and rake up pine straw and make circles around the trees and pretend that we were playing house.
Mm-hmm.
And one afternoon, the teacher was distracted talking to another teacher, and these boys from the middle school showed up behind where we were at and grabbed a bunch of us girls and dragged us off behind this fence that was covered in a vine so the teacher couldn't see us. And they were about to do bad things to us. And they had already started. I mean, I'm not going to go into detail what they were doing, but I was one of them they grabbed, and I had a little friend, and she says, "I'm sorry about this. I know these boys, and they should, you know, I can't stop them from doing it." So she knew who they were. Mm-hmm. And then the teacher blew the whistle, and we couldn't come because we were secured.
Mm-hmm.
So the whistle started getting more fervent, and the boys ran and left us sitting there. So when we came back to the, because they untied us and then ran off. And so when we came back to the teacher says, "You didn't come to this whistle, so I'm going to power you." And I'm like, "No, you're not. I want my daddy."
Mm-hmm.
So she hauled me off to the principal's office, and the principal says, "Why won't you let her?" I said, "Because she's going to whip me for something I had no control over."
Right.
So when my dad got there and I told the whole thing, it was like the principal was like, he couldn't believe his ears.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I was never disrespectful the whole time. I just told the teacher, "No, you're not going to hit me.
Yeah.
I don't deserve to be whipped for what you're going to whip me for."
Right. And I think that's so important for us to teach our children to advocate for themselves.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's really important.
Things happen. Robin says, "I do not disrespect anyone and will not tolerate being disrespectful or be, oh, sorry. I will not tolerate being disrespected. I will not walk on eggshells either."
Yeah. Yep. Trying to line this thing up.
Why is every time I make one of these, I always have a one piece off? I really think you can take this out. But the other one looks fine. Actually, I am going to take it out and redo it. I wish we had flea markets and used stores here where you could go and see what, you know, other people have given up.
Yeah. That's what my mom says too, because we don't have those in Jamaica.
Yeah. Definitely. I don't even have a fabric store here. They sell sewing machines, which I find interesting, but they don't have fabric to buy.
Wow. So you can't buy fabric in Greenland, but you can buy a sewing machine.
Where I live at, there's no fabric. Now, there is a small fabric store in Nuuk, but most of it's not quilting fabric. It's fabric to make, I don't know, clothing and household stuff out of.
Mm-hmm. That's so interesting.
Tiny. Yep. And I, you know, as many times as I've been to Denmark, it's really difficult finding a quote unquote quilt store. Now, mm-hmm. where I bought my sewing machine from, she has fabric. Some of it's cotton, and I bought some stuff, but it's not exactly a fabric. It's not a quilt shop. It's more of a Most of the fabric in there is also for making clothes.
Mm-hmm. That's so
there is
interesting.
Quilt places there. I just haven't been able to find them because where they're at, I'm not. You know, I would have to take a train or drive to get there. So I just order everything from the United States because at least I know what I'm getting.
Hardest part for me with the legit kits is when you're sewing on a diagonal line and you're trying to line the fabric up because it's not like, you know, the fabric they're not symmetric.
Yeah.
They're kind of off, and then you have to figure out what angle you need to sew it at to get it to fall in its place, like this piece here. So I'm sewing this piece on.
Yeah.
I'm trying to lay it so that when it falls along that diagonal line.
Oh.
It's very, so I have to sew it like this so that it can fit this spot over here. That's the hardest part for me.
Yep, I'm sure I'm going to be getting to discover that same problem.
Yeah.
There's so many little tiny angles I've noticed on some of those.
Yes.
When people are following them.
Yeah.
I would really like to know if after my turn,
excuse me.
Going to redo this one side of this flying piece because it's just not sitting well. I don't know why I have such trouble with flying bees.
Flying geese are very intimidating for me.
Yeah.
I'm having such a hard time with half square triangles.
Ah.
I just don't think we're friends. I don't think we're gonna be friends. Maybe one day. I don't know. I think it's just the way it is right now that we're just not friends. I posted a short recently after doing this Tree of Life block. That's this one over my shoulder here.
Uh-huh.
32 half square triangles. 32 2-inch half square triangles.
Ooh, those are small ones.
In that one block. Oh, I'm like, God. I'm breaking up with half square triangles. The relationship is over.
I did a mystery quilt where you had to make 480 of them.
Wow. The worst part is squaring them up.
Well, I
You
used
know, I
triangle
mean.
paper, so I didn't have to do too much squaring up. I mean, you still have to trim a little bit sometimes. When I saw 480 of them, I'm like, I'm not drawing lines. No, not happening.
Yes.
You're going to use
That's
paper.
another thing. That's another thing, drawing those lines.
Yep, drawing those lines. That's right. Drawing those annoying lines. Frank says he didn't realize he had so much to do. What do you got to do, Frank? My mind's going to know.
Katie, I think when I'm finished with this block here, that will be it for me for today.
Okay. Yep. It'll give me a time to have a break between the next one. That one's going to be about, I don't know. It'll depend on how long it takes me to quilt or how long I decide to keep quilting during the live anyway. Because we've been working on I don't have a name for my quilt yet. So I'm calling it the quilt with no name. But today we are going to do diagonal line straight stitch quilting on
Okay.
but I need to finish basting it and get it laid out where I can put my first line. I'm going to use painter tape to establish that first center line, and because I'm going to start in the center from the outside center to all the way to the other end center, and then work my way out from the center on both sides of that center line.
I'm hand quilting two baby quilts as well
Nice.
for a coworker of mine that just had twins. But I'm hand quilting it.
So,
So
how long does it usually take you to hand quilt a quilt?
it takes a while, depending on how intricate I hand quilt. You
Okay.
know, if I just quilt along the seam lines, it's not that it could possibly take me two nights or so to complete one baby quilt. But if I do a more intricate design, it will take longer. Also, she doesn't know I'm making them, so I'm not under any deadline. I figure the babies will be able to use it.
Yep.
You know, my goal is to try to get it to her before she returns to work.
Well, maybe you will.
I have a couple months.
So when we get ready to end the bonnet, live, don't run off from Zoom yet. I want to talk to you for a minute.
Okay, no problem.
I would like to do another show with you if you're interested.
I would. I'm really enjoying today.
Yeah.
Also, I love hearing your story, Katie. I think it's so interesting and so important. You know, and I love hearing you talk about your life and your life in Greenland.
Yeah, you know, I'm very blessed because, you know, most people don't get second chances then. You know, and
Yes.
I didn't think that I would ever know what being happy meant, and being able to live without worrying about someone putting me down or
Yes.
having to walk on eggshells all the time to keep from being yelled at. And it was, you know, the first couple of, I have to tell you a little story about the first time he got annoyed about something. But you know, now things are getting, as time has progressed, I'm having less triggers.
Yeah.
Some triggers we discovered I didn't know I had, those have, you know, manifested itself. But he when it happens, and you know, if it happens when he's here, he sees it before it actually happens. Come and say, what do you need? What can I do? Especially when it comes to having people over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just he Nikolai's it's an ex I always say this. He's an exceptional human being. He gives without wanting, he gives without expecting something. Does it because that's who he is.
Yeah.
And I've never been around anyone like that, where he, you know, he's always got this positive outlook on life. He usually doesn't let people get under his skin, and you know, he's not, he's never combative. The only time he would actually be combative is if somebody says something mean to his wife. Then he'll be there to defend, you know, and he's told me this. He says, I will defend you to the death. I'm like, you don't have to. But the fact that
It's
he
so good
says
to
that,
have.
yeah, the fact that he says that he would stand up for me, or you know, do whatever it took, that's more than I've had my whole life. You know. And so I don't know, I was here about a year, and we're still learning each other. So one of the things is I had this habit of walking in when he's playing a certain kind of game, which now he doesn't play him when if he knows I'm going to interrupt him, he'll play a different kind of game. And one day he says, "You got me killed." And I thought he was angry. So I walked for 2 hours, I walked around like I was on eggshells. And the last one time I come walking by, and I wasn't talking either because I was afraid. And he says, "Hey, babe, come here." So I did. He says, "What is wrong with you? What do you mean? You've been walking around here like you're afraid of me." I said, "Well, you're mad at me." And he says, "Honey, I forgot about this 5 minutes after I said something. I'm not mad at you. I was just annoyed." So I've had to learn the difference between anger and being annoyed. They're two different entirely things, two entirely different things. We didn't even have an argument that day. It was just he said something, and I took it to be, you know, he was mad. And it was, you know, it was
And that's your trauma response,
yep, exactly. So
I know I grew up with a lot of trauma too,
then you
and
understand
I've never spoken about it on this on my channel, but I grew up with a lot of trauma, and I'm just now learning tools. And also working through triggers and so on, and it's a lot. And in Jamaica, we the one of the I hope this doesn't get me in trouble, but one of the statistics that I grew up hearing was one out of every four women
Yeah.
is abused.
That doesn't surprise
And so if you're in a room with 10 women, count 1, 2, 3, 4, you're probably going to come across two or three at least women
Yeah.
who've suffered some sort of abuse or trauma. And I think that it's important to talk about it, because when we were growing up, it was always taboo. You
Yeah,
keep
you don't
some things
speak about it.
quiet.
You don't tell
You don't
anyone.
talk about it. But it can no longer be taboo. We have to get past that. So,
yeah. You know, talking about this and talking about mental health, all this kind of things that relates to how humans function as humans has to be mm-hmm. talked about so that, yes. you know, people don't spend a lifetime in misery.
Yeah.
And human beings are their own best advocates. They can advocate for each other.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Unless you're in a society where you can't.
Yeah.
And there is something that have societies where you can't do it. But I mentioned, you know, it's like what we're talking about right now, you know,
mm-hmm.
You can't tell a story about how right. you got, like how I got to Greenland, because what happened in the past is what brought me to where I am now.
Right.
And, and so a lot of times, you know, when these conversations come up, I get uncomfortable. But it's really who I am, and I can't make up some lie of how I got yeah. here.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. I mean, and I understand that it is uncomfortable. And also, I mean, especially when you're talking about things that happened in your past, it wasn't just you. Other people are also involved.
Yes.
So when you're talking about them, talking about you, you're also talking about others, and other people might feel exposed or vulnerable, you know?
Yeah.
But it's your story and it's their story, and you're entitled to your story.
Yep.
I guess I'm sounding like a teacher now. But I firmly believe that.
Trauma can be a lot, you know, it's like a little, I don't know.
Yeah.
Like a little.
Yes. But you should never be made.
It doesn't manifest. Sometimes it doesn't manifest itself until something triggers it.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Something happened to me recently, and I was actually shocked at my own response. You know, and uh-huh. I had to go back and examine
why
did that happen, you know, and what was the thing that triggered it? And it was something that I didn't even remember that yeah. had happened when I was younger, when I was a child, that was a trigger, and I had no idea. So
I had one of my weird triggers is a certain word. Somebody will say something, use a word, mm-hmm. and it instantly takes me back to something in my childhood, which I mm-hmm. hate when that happens.
Yeah.
Can't do anything about it. You just have to deal with it as it comes.
Yeah.
And I truly believe that I'm here in Greenland just so I can heal and feel love.
Yes.
And I do feel love. See you later, Frank. I'm coming along with this bomb pop. I'm fixing to show you the next section I've done. That was garbled.
Let's see how this
is coming along. I'm finished in this live, but we're coming along.
I'm going to have to get my seam ripper out first time Uh-oh. This morning.
I'm for but a it's... date with Jack.
It's fine. I I rarely use my seam ripper because if I can live with the mistake,
Yep.
I'm letting it stay, you know. So
every now and then I break it out if I'm just really unhappy. Like I just did it with that twine piece because it just was bugging me.
I mean, sometimes you just have to take it out, but you don't have to. If I can live with it, I'm leaving it. That was a quick and easy fix. So it isn't so bad. Lost my piece again.
I'm going to put this other one pressed, and then I'll show it to you guys.
Found it. I keep losing things.
Sometimes I tell my husband I think this house eats things because I'll lay it down and when I come back it's not there anymore, which means I moved it somewhere else.
Yep.
So here's the next section, and based on how the picture is wanting to look at it, this is how you're supposed to see it.
Nice.
So I had to make two of these.
Nice. I got my pattern clue. I got clue number one for the.
Find it?
Yeah, I'm doing the, let me get it over here.
Tell everybody what you're doing.
I'm doing autumn shades of the Tree of Life. And I got the clue one. I got clue one. But I have not received the fabric yet.
Yeah.
So
did a lot of mailing out Friday, but.
Yes, it's going to take a little while.
Yep.
You know, to get here. So I'm excited because I've not done one before.
Did you, are you going to do it by the month or did you buy the whole kit?
I bought the whole kit.
Awesome. I bought, I'm doing two of them, but one of them is a whole kit. The other one is by the month.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's start this next part.
Yep, I'm pretty excited.
I know I am too. I can't wait to see what everybody does.
Yeah.
It seems like there's a lot more, seems like we're going to have a lot of new people doing it for the first time, which I think is awesome.
Yeah. Jumped on the bandwagon.
Yep. Oh, no wonder I didn't see that one. This is right above the keyboard. B. I need to make two of these. And E. So how's everybody's weather today where you're at? Tell me what the weather's like everywhere.
It seems like it's warm here today. I really haven't ventured outside, but I guess I could look on the phone. Well, it's not that warm. It's 46 degrees. I guess it depends. I mean, warm is relative, right?
Yeah.
It's 46 degrees here. Looks like it's going to be a nice day.
Oh, that's good. It's 4 degrees here.
4 degrees.
4 degrees Fahrenheit. Yep.
Oh, wow. Those are unheard of.
We got 2 days of snow, and my goodness, when you walk out the door, you get blinded.
Wow.
It is, I'm sure, because the sun is shining.
Beautiful.
It is. I was thinking about taking the phone outside and showing everybody how much snow we got. I don't, you know, hopefully it'll stick around a little bit. We'll see.
Of course, you know, we don't have snow in Jamaica.
Nope. Does it ever and, get cool? Does it ever get like chilly there?
It gets probably about in the 60s.
Okay.
Maybe in certain parts where there's high elevation, it might get up to in somewhere in the 50s.
Uh-huh.
But that's very unusual. Nice weather, cold weather for us would be in the 60s. Like, if okay. It's in the 60s, it's cold.
When you were living there, did you ever experience any hurricanes?
Oh, yes. Our hurricanes are a part of life in the Caribbean.
Yeah, like they're a part of Florida, yeah.
Yep. Like every year, almost, there is some sort of hurricane or tropical storm. And the devastation from that is usually caused by flooding. So, yeah, we have had some very, very significant hurricanes in Jamaica. But hurricanes are like the first time I came here and there was a tropical storm. And they closed the schools and they were sending everyone home. And I was like, it's just a tropical storm. Why is everybody getting excited?
Yeah. It's as Florida people, we're made of tough stuff. We don't panic when we're going to get a hurricane.
Yeah. It's like,
it'd
okay.
Have to be a category 4 before we start sweating bullets.
Right, right. Of course, I mean, it depends on what part of the island you live and what,
yeah,
you know, and all of that. But for us, I'm a city girl. I grew up mostly in Kingston. And for me, you know, it's not a great worry because, you know that the house is well built and, you know, the infrastructure is there.
Yeah.
To counteract the flooding and all of that, but for some people it's really devastating.
Yeah. I think hurricanes are so beautiful when you look at them on the satellite. Yes. I'm like, that is nature at her best. And yeah. Tornadoes are when she's really mad and wants to clean up fast.
Mm-hmm. So I'm finished now. This is the second.
Let me get to where I can everybody can see. Mm-hmm. Hang on a minute. Spotlight you? All right. Here we go.
So we have, I finished two parts.
That looks great.
Thank you.
I like the colors you're using. So is the vortex all blues and all different shades of blue?
No, it has oranges, reds, yellows. It's all colors of the rainbow.
Would you like to show the rest of them that you already done?
Sure.
All right, it's going to take me a little while to get these off. So I've been putting them together as I sew them. So this is a part of it.
Ooh, that looks great. I love the warm colors you put in with it.
Yeah. And then this is another part here.
Nice. That looks really good.
And then the biggest part is this part. All right.
Wow, look at that. That looks wonderful. You're doing a super duper good job of it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let me see here. Lisette, I hope I said her name right, says, looks great, Janice.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is where we're going to stop the live. Thank you everyone for coming on the live, and thank you for giving Janice a warm welcome. Don't forget, and I'll type her channel name in the channel one more time. If you're not subscribed to Janice, please go over and share some love and subscribe to her channel to help it grow, because she would appreciate it. And
thank you to everyone who has subscribed so far. I've seen a number of notifications, so thank you.
Yep, every little bit helps. So thank you for that. And I'm going to let you say what you want to say.
Thank you so much. I just enjoyed spending time with you, Katy. I have always been fascinated by your story. And I love every time you share about Greenland and about your journey, it inspires me. Thank you. Thank you for that.
And I know that you probably can relate, since you have done migration yourself. You know, it's not an easy task when you pull up your roots from one place that you've known all your life to go live somewhere else that you've never been to or ever thought about being to. There's a lot that goes into the sacrifices made and whether you know, and it's scary.
It is. It is.
You don't know what's going to happen. Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah. Yeah. Thank you for coming on the live with me. And I definitely, let's sew again. That's what I really like to do. So,
absolutely.
So see everybody tonight at 7 Greenland time, which is 4:00 Eastern Standard Time. We will be working on the quilt with no name, because I'm going to start the quilting process of it. And see you on the next video, and have a great afternoon. Bye.
Bye.